Everyone, welcome to the UkeStuff channel and to the Tech in Music Ed channel. I'm going to post this on both sites, but for Christmas, I was given a 3D printer by my parents, and I've been printing 3D ukuleles. And just tonight, I had the idea about printing a tuba mouthpiece. And the reason is because of this mouthpiece. This is made by Kelly Mouthpieces, and it's made of Lexan. They've been doing this for quite a while now, and I've been playing one of these for a long time on tuba. I used to play metal mouthpieces, and I know that there's still a lot of people that just only want to play a metal mouthpiece. They think that that gives you the best response and everything. That's great, but for my casual playing these days, where I might play for an event or I might play with a band, but I don't play all the time. It's not my primary gig. This does the trick. It's never cold, so if you're playing outside, it doesn't freeze to your lips. I remember marching situations like that that just weren't good, especially in drum corps. So this has been wonderful. Well, one of these went missing, and we actually just found it a few days ago when my wife was cleaning with my 8-year-old son, cleaning out his room and doing some modifications in his room. As they went through all the toys, we did one of those, you know, once every few years of toys where you sort out the toys you're giving away, toys you're throwing away, and toys you're going to store, as well as toys you're going to keep. In one of the bins, they found my mouthpiece. So at some point, my 8-year-old son had stolen my mouthpiece, and I had needed it last spring and had to buy another one of these. So I have a second one of those around. Well, I've had the 3D printer since Christmas, and just today I was looking up different ukuleles to print and things like that, because it's just a fun thing to do. And I had the, you know, sort of mind thought of, what if I printed a mouthpiece? So tonight I printed a mouthpiece. And in fact, I'll show you just a short video of that right here on the side. And that's just it printing towards the end. And this is a recreation of a Dennis Kirk mouthpiece made with crystal PLA. So it's definitely not metal. And here it is in comparison with sort of the Helleberg. This would be like the Con Helleberg style. And then this is the Dennis Kirk, very much deeper. And what I'm going to do is play each of those for you. Now, to those of you watching on the UkeStuff channel, this isn't ukulele, but this is my life before ukulele. And I just thought I would share it because it's kind of fun. So here is my personal ukulele, not ukulele. This is my personal tuba. This is my Treveni tuba that I've had since college. So it's getting towards 20-some years in existence. And this is with the Kellyberg mouthpiece. So I'm sitting on kind of a raised chair, so I'll do my best here. And a pedal tone. So, and I'm a little bit out of practice, but that's okay. And here is this mouthpiece. This is the first time I have played it. It's generally pretty smooth. There's some sharper edges on the inside, but it's not like cut you sharp, but it's just not perfectly smooth on the inside, like probably the metal one would be, but it does fit in. Let's see what it sounds like. Let's see if I can even do a pedal with that really large chamber. Oh yeah. Now, in comparison with the Lexan mouthpiece, boy, the location changes. So right now I do like the response of this one better, but I'm not used to playing on such a deep mouthpiece. It would probably be better for me to print one of the Helleberg models that are out there rather than this one, but I thought, why not start with something bigger? It's lighter too, a little bit, with the PLA, and it's not as dense of a material. Well, it's definitely usable, And I will probably just print yet another style of this and see how that responds as well. All right, thanks for joining me on this short tuba journey, either on the UkeStuff channel or the Tech in Music Ed channel. And for those of you that watch UkeStuff channel, I'll be back soon with some more UkeStuff.